Hi, this is Ali and you are watching the ChatGPT Features video series on Learn Awesome. In this video, we shall discuss large language models. Starting off with the question, what is ChatGPT? And the one-liner answer is, it is a large language model. The follow-up question would be, what is a large language model? Or rather, what is a machine learning or AI model in the first place? A machine learning model is an algorithm that can find patterns or make decisions from previously unseen dataset. Those learning algorithms try to mimic what neuroscientists believe is the way our brain works. They are broadly categorized as unsupervised and supervised learning algorithms. In unsupervised, the model is fed a large amount of data and it tries to find relationships between the elements of the data. Since we are in context of language, this type of learning would result in model deriving relationships between words, sentences, and concepts. In supervised learning, the model is trained to produce a specific output given a specific input. An example can be a spider trying to identify the type of insect that landed on outer periphery of its web by iteratively adjusting tension on its web strings, just like you adjust your guitar strings, until she gets the correct signal for the type of insect. How do you learn a new language? You start by seeing your parents speaking and develop understanding of some words like hello or goodbye when parents are leaving or coming back to the house, and are able to associate words with situations or actions. Your parents teach you about basic vocabulary, let's say things in the house. Then in school, you are taught alphabets and grammar rules, and then you read books. Being in the process repeatedly for a while, you get a hang of the rules of the language and understand the patterns in written and spoken language. And then you are able to learn any new book or come up with your own versions of phrases. Then your parents fine-tune you in avoiding slang and what kind of language to speak or write in different situations, that is, informal and final formats of the language. Language models are taught almost in a similar way as humans, the difference being they are able to read not one, not a dozen, hundreds or thousands, but almost the entire internet. Compared to other crawlers on the web, let's say the Google crawlers which can scan the internet to build page rank for its search algorithm, mostly restricted to words and links, language model crawlers, since they are trained for natural language, has much more to absorb from vast information available on the internet and make them available to you when you ask them a question in natural language. So large language models are first trained on unsupervised and unlabeled data until it develops an understanding of relationships between words, phrases, and concepts. Then they are passed through various deep learning techniques to deepen the learned relationships and scoring and prioritizing the response it generates given an input. Languages are based on grammars, that is, rules, and therefore there are patterns in language. Recognizing whom is the job of the AI model. Once a machine learning model understands those patterns, it is able to predict and even generate text given its vocabulary and vast knowledge at its disposal. A large language model is a machine learning or artificial intelligence algorithm used to understand, summarize, generate, and predict new content. Any language model is able to crawl the resources on internet, but it's not about how much information it can digest. Its core competency is being able to come up with answers you, its users, are asking. That requires the ability to index gathered information for efficient retrieval, prioritize available answers to come up with the best one, and present them in the form the user requires. They also need ability to understand the question in natural language and be able to infer requirements and retrieve information accordingly. Having a natural language-based training allows them the awesome ability to transform unstructured data into structured format and do operations any good programmer would require a long time to do. Language models are a fascinating world in itself, and I would, with your encouragement in form of likes, subscribes, and comments, will try to build a separate video or playlist for them. But for now, I'll hold myself back and restrict myself to the language model that is the ChatGPT. In the next video, we'll introduce the ChatGPT itself. If you liked the video, please consider liking and subscribing. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.